Going on, guys? Welcome, Rabbit here, and we're going to look at some Zeph hash rates as well as XMR because it does use the same algorithm, so the hash rates are going to be the same. But we're going to be using the Ryzen 9 3900X. Now, as you can see, this thing has a beast of a cooler. This is the Noctua NHD15. Definite overkill for this CPU. But this is my first dedicated mining rig. This thing has been up and running for over 3 or 4 years, 24/7. This is the first rig one that I definitely built as a dedicated CPU mining rig, and I went all out here with the cooler and stuff, obviously, and it is still running 100%. So we're gonna test some hash rates here. I hope I can get at the RAM. It looks like there's a slot down there. You know, Noctua knows what they're doing. I might be able to slide one in there. I wanna try 2 sticks versus 4 sticks as well with XMP profiles on and off. But we're gonna see what we can do now. Here's some Zeph hash rates, Ryzen 9 3900X. So just to start things off, I wanna see what my default settings were at. And it looks like I do have this thing at 3.6 and 2400 megahertz on the RAM. This is 3200 CL13 or CL14 RAM. So XMP profile is not on. So what do I have for voltages on this guy anyway? If I scroll down here, I can see, so 3.6, and I am at, what is that down there? 9.7, so 0.97 volts. Let's see what kind of hash rates we're getting right now and what our power consumption is. All right, guys, so it looks like we're about 12.2 kilohash, which is, you know, the average hash rate running nice and efficient on these 3900Xs. Taking a look at our power consumption, we are only rocking 107 to 108 watts. Extremely efficient, running at only 3.6 and 0.97 volts. And these Noctua fans don't use much power at all. Okay, so I am back in the BIOS, and all I'm gonna do here, I'm keeping all the settings the same, but I'm just enabling that XMP profile one. This is just your default stock overclock settings built within the RAM to run it at that 3200 megahertz. And we're gonna see what kind of hash rate boost we get as well as extra power it pulls. Hit that. Save, good, let it reboot. All right, so with that XMP profile turned on, we are now at about 12.7 kilohash, which is about 500 hashes more. And we are at about 117 and a half watts here, so we are up almost 10 watts, about 9.5 or so. That's about what we do see, about 10 watts when it does come to the CL14 G-Skill Flare RAM. Now, if you're dealing with CL16, CL18, you do start to notice smaller improvements because the timing is a little looser there, but they also use more power. So CL14, while it's more expensive, I do find it's also less on the power consumption. All right, guys, so I took 2 more sticks out of rig 2. I got 4 sticks in now. We got XMP profile on again. So I just want to see how this does compare with 4 sticks versus 2 sticks and if we see improvements. Now, obviously, running 4 sticks in a CPU mining rig like this for Random X or something is going to get pretty expensive loading up on RAM, especially good RAM like this RAM here. I don't build with these. My first, I think 10 rigs or something did have that RAM, but I found them all on sale for like 70 bucks. Now they're upwards of $140 to $200 for the single kit of 2 sticks. So I haven't been using those to build anymore because their price just exploded to stupid prices. So it'd be very expensive to do this today. So I just wanted to test it though, to see how this will do though. All right, so it does look like we gained about 300 hashes there. We're at 13 kilohash. As for our power, we are about 123.7 watts. So we did go up about 6 watts and gained again, only like 300 hashes. So obviously we got a beast cooler on this thing. So our temperatures are looking pretty good. So I wanna crank it up a bit till we get a stable CPU. And then I'm gonna enable the DRAM calculator timings and see what kind of hash rate we can get. Can we push 15 kilohash on this, 15,000 hash or something? I have done it in the past, but I think that was only with 2 sticks. So we should see a little bit more. Also on AMD's website, whoa, that focuses. We can say our base clock is 3.8 and our boost is upwards of, wherever I can find it, right above it there, 4.6. So I might try 4.2, 4.3, and kind of see what things look like. When I'm done, I might leave the settings at around 3.7, 3.8 in that base clock range and tweak some voltages and then have just 2 sticks of RAM and XMP profile turned on for Zeph. But you know what? I'll see what happens with the sides by the end of this video. But let's see what kind of hash rate we can pull out of this thing now. Okay, so here you can see the miner is starting and then it keeps quitting here. And that is because I'm teetering right at the voltage limit. Right now I'm currently at 4.3 and 1.23 volts. So I'm gonna have to give it a little bit more voltage here. All right guys, so for some reason it didn't wanna run at 4.3 gigahertz. Even at 1.25 volts, it would just keep stuttering, not do anything. So I dropped it down to 4.25. Now I don't remember, you know, a couple of years back when I hit 15,300 hashes, 15.3, I can't remember exactly what the Ryzen clock tuner was telling me. So right now we're at 4.25. We're gonna start with the power consumption. I want you guys to stop right now, go to the comment section. Let me know if we beat my previous record of 15.3 kilohash or 15,300 hashes. So we're gonna start with the power here. We're currently at about 213 watts. And our hash rate is 15.5 kilohash. The high is 15.7 kilohash on a Ryzen 9 3900X. Look at that, Hive is telling us 15.6 kilohash, and our temps are still only 67 degrees. This cooler is absolute beast mode, and I can prove right here, you can see Ryzen 9 3900X 12 core processor is rocking 15.6 kilohash. So I did beat my old record here. Four sticks of RAM did it, but we are using a lot of power. All right, so I am back down to two sticks of RAM inside this. I gotta get those two sticks back into rig two, which is pretty much an identical rig to this. I did settle at about 3.7 and I'm at 0.98 volts. So I'm gonna have to watch this one, just like my 5950X, like the other day. I changed the settings around, so I'm gonna have to watch it for a few days, make sure it's stable, and then I'll probably change rig two and stuff around because they're 3900Xs. Same with rig five, I think it's at 3.6, so I'll move them up a little bit as well. But right now I'm back at the 3.7, 0.98, two sticks of RAM, XMP profile turned on for the RandomX algorithm. So hopefully this helps you out in figuring out some Ryzen 9 3900X RandomX, that's your Zeph, as well as Monero and other coins that use RandomX, the same hash rate will follow suit on all of those coins for this CPU. So that's pretty awesome there. I'm glad I did get to break my other record. So that's pretty sweet as well. Pretty darn awesome. I guess next time maybe we can get some liquid nitrogen in here. Maybe somehow if I could run this at 1.5 volts, we might be able to get this a lot higher. I might try some more testing in the future. If we can break 16 and a half kilohash, that'd be pretty sweet, but we're gonna be using a lot of power. Regardless, there's a lot of things that do play when it comes to power. Obviously, RAM sticks, they'll all have different power consumption. I kind of mentioned that earlier, CL14 versus 16 versus 18. The 18 gives you the least amount of performance boost. Even though it is faster, 3600 megahertz RAM, it gives you the least boost on mining, and it also increases your power the most. So keep those things in mind. The motherboard, whether it's an X570, B450, B550, X470, this is an X470 MSI. So different motherboards will use different power consumption as well. So those are other things to keep in mind. Regardless, thank you for checking out this video, guys. I will see you on the next one. Rabbit out.